Welcome into the recap of the Bears blowout loss to the Lions in Detroit today. I'm David Kaplan. It's brought to you by Chevy Drive Chicago. com. Folks, what you watched today was coaching malpractice. No, they were never going to win this game. And the people out there that were picking the Bears to win and the people that thought this game's going to be tight, the Bears are a live dog. Are you people out of your mind? Did you watch them get the ever-living shit beaten out of them today? Justin Fields ran for his life. Well, Cap, he only threw for 47 yards. Folks, he's got no receivers. He's got no offensive line. Two of his starters got taken out on carts today, and he keeps getting hit, and our idiotic head coach keeps him in the game. Stupid, dumb coaching. First of all, by losing, you guarantee at least the number two pick in the draft. Guess what? You want to lose. You know how you get better? You don't learn to win with a roster of half of whom are not going to be here. You learn to win by getting better goddamn players. I don't understand when you're down 38-10 and this kid keeps getting hit. He gets evaluated for a concussion. They've got to work on him on the sidelines because his leg was bothering him, whether it was a cramp or whatever it was. At 38-10, you've got to be brain dead to keep that kid in the game. Guess what? The Jacksonville Jaguars, who are probably not winning the Super Bowl this year, when they had a 28-3 lead, they sat their starting quarterback, Trevor Lawrence, same draft class as Justin Fields. They sat their starting running back, Travis Etienne, and they sat other starters. They said, we're not losing this game, and we're not getting our guys hurt. And our brain-dead coaching staff keeps this kid out there to keep getting hit. He's been sacked, what, six times today? That's just dumb, dumb, dumb. The Lions have a very talented team. Are they a great team? No. Do they need more talent defensively? Yes. The Bears have holes all over their freaking roster. They've got no receivers. They've got a very shoddy offensive line. And please stop sending me tweets. Braxton Jones has had a really good year, Cap. Did you watch him get just used like a turnstile all day today? As I came out here, I heard holding 70 offense. Guess what? That's the only way he slowed anyone down today, by trying to hold on to him. He's okay. He's going to develop. He's got to get stronger. But stop telling me we've solved the left tackle for the next decade with Braxton Jones. Stop. It's just dumb, dumb narrative. It's a bad goddamn team. It has very little talent, and you're risking your future at quarterback in a 38-10 blowout. I don't get it. I'll never get it. Just please do not let this kid get hurt. If you play him against Minnesota, it will be the dumbest coaching decision I'll have seen in a long time. Bears get the ever-living shit beaten out of them today in Detroit. And guess what? They were never in the football game. That's just a fact. Now lock up the number two pick. Houston got crushed today. They'd have to win next week, and I don't think they will. Pick number two, trade down, get a bunch more picks, and start adding talent to this awful roster. Have a great rest of your day. Happy, healthy New Year to all of you. Take that.